What makes a terrorist? Poverty? Illiteracy? Watch this video to find out. Everybody says poverty and illiteracy fuel terrorism, that the underprivileged are easily misled into killing others in the name of religion. Is it true? Let's check. There were 9 suicide bombers in the April 21 Colombo attack, mostly well-educated and from wealthy families. 8 have been identified and one of them was a woman. One of the attackers was Abdul Latif Jamil Muhammad, who studied aerospace engineering at Kingston University in London from 2006 to 2007. He went on to study his postgraduate degree in Australia before leaving in 2013 to return to Sri Lanka. 2 of the bombers were brothers, the sons of one of Sri Lanka's wealthiest spice traders. One, Inshaf Ibrahim, who owned a copper factory, was the one who detonated his explosive device at the busy breakfast buffet of the luxurious Shangri-La Hotel. The other brother, Ilham Ibrahim, detonated his device at the Cinnamon Grand Hotel restaurant. You think Sri Lankan terrorists were exceptions? All those who flew planes into New York's World Trade Center on 9/11 were from affluent backgrounds. Muhammad Atta, for instance, was born to wealthy parents, studied architecture from Cairo University and then urban planning from Germany. 2/3 of 9/11 attackers had degrees. 9/11 mastermind Osama bin Laden was son of a construction tycoon and went on to elite secular school and university. His successor and current Al-Qaeda chief, Ayman al-Zawahiri, is a qualified pediatrician. One plot in Britain in 2007 was almost entirely devised by highly qualified doctors and medical experts. Bangladeshi ISIS terrorists, including Tamim Chowdhury, who killed 20 hostages in upscale Holy Artisan Bakery in Dhaka in 2016, were from wealthy, highly educated backgrounds. Genius of Jihad, Anwar al-Awlaki's father, was a Fulbright scholar and doctorate. Awlaki himself did bachelor's in civil engineering from Colorado State University in the US and was working on his doctorate. The Pakistani terrorist and killer of journalist Daniel Pearl, Omar Saeed Sheikh, comes from an extremely wealthy family settled in Britain. He studied in London School of Economics. So, some of the leading lights of terrorism and religious fanaticism come from well-off, highly educated backgrounds. Poverty and illiteracy are not necessarily the fodder for terror. The worst monsters have walked out of posh villas and cool cars to kill and maim hundreds of innocent. Terrorism is a state of mind.